In today's episode, I'm going to teach you a really cool RSpec trick called aggregating failures. And what this does is if this first expectation fails for whatever reason, it'll keep running the other expectations. So this can be quite useful for if you've got like a very long test with a lot going on, and maybe that first failure is useful to know, but there's some additional failures below it, which will give you more of a hint as to what's going on. So let's kind of jump into this. So in the documentation, they've got like a little example here where they wrap the expectation in a block. So let's quickly do that. So I'm going to do aggregate failures, and we're going to see what happens here. So I'm going to quickly run this file now, bundle exec, rspec, and I think this is in spec, models, and postspec. Okay. There we go. So we can see it has just run these first two expectations. It got here and said, "Oh, nope, those things didn't pass. I'm not going to let you go any further," which is quite cool. So let's kind of turn these up on their head. Let's turn these around and say, "Okay, expect to not equal." So these should now pass, and we'll get to here. Cool. Okay, it's now saying, okay, I didn't expect this to equal fruit and pies. Well, I expect this to equal fruit and pies even, and it's got down to here. So that's quite nice. So what if we want to do this for our whole test? Like maybe we want to apply this to the test, but not nest things as heavily. Well, we can do that. We can add this aggregate failures to the metadata, which is like this. And that'll just pretty much wrap this whole test in a block. And let us run the whole thing. So let's see what that does. Awesome. It just ran all three of these expectations and they all failed, and we got a lot of information about that. So I really like this. I think this is a really handy thing to be doing, just because like quite often that first failure might be something quite generic and you might want to drill down a bit more or what have you. So hopefully you found this useful, and I look forward to seeing you next week.